play. You know, I think we executed offensively and defensively pretty well. Sustained level of play, and I mean, everybody contributed.
I guess the shoulder wasn't bothering you towards the end. You got flat on that screen and then hit a couple jumpers right
after. Yeah, it was my left shoulder, so I'll be all right.
Coach said he came up to you and said it was such a different and powerful player with a good physical impact. When does that mentality change with it? Because it sometimes feels like it goes from first half to second half.
Just sometimes I got to get myself going, you know, on some like intangible type plays, whether it be like an offensive rebound or a tip in or a hustle play or something, like an offensive foul. It doesn't always have to be like a three or a jumper or something like that. It can be like within the game, you know what I mean? Within the game, and that's kind of what gets me going. And then I need to understand, just continue to be in attack mode, just play downhill. Get to the cup and try and finish.
You know, like a football player, it's like they don't put things in the pit. Physically, looks like that. I'm wondering if it's a physical nature for you too.
I'm like the same kind of way. You know, I'm the same kind of way. You know, it takes I don't know, just something. You know, and it shouldn't be like that. You know, I'm usually very self-motivated. I'm just gonna take it upon myself to just come out with that mentality because it'll help the team.
Was there a specific incident tonight?
I was trying to be aggressive on the offensive glass pretty much the whole time. I'm looking to improve my help defense. I think my on-ball defense is, you know, top tier, but my help defense is lacking. So I'm just gonna continue to help my teammates out in the gap. You know, do more on the defensive end.
You guys have 9 games left. It's been a long season. You played a lot of minutes. Physically, how do you feel at this point in your
career? The best I've ever felt in my life.
The Clippers kind of just single digits late in this game. You guys are up pretty big, but you're able to put them away. A lot of three-pointers. You had that big dunk. What was working for you guys late in the game to make that happen?
I mean, we were just playing through big fellas. You know, he was making the right decisions and the right reads. And, everybody was ready to shoot, ready to make the play.
The coverage that teams have been throwing at him, the fronting and then the help on the backside. How many other guys in the league have you ever seen be covered like that?
Since I've been in the league, not many. Him, maybe JoJo on some nights. Other than that, I mean, he's getting doubled and triple teamed, so you know he's got to be ready.
The message after the Celtics game, they kind of take it to you guys, coach, Petrus, the entire starting line, ahead of the code. Was there anything said after that game that really you guys wanted to take into this one that helped you guys start the way that you did?
No, we just knew we needed to respond, bounce back, be more physical, be more locked in, pay more attention to detail. Understand that it is a long season, people are tired, so we just had to get our energy up and kind of get the morale back. I put the blame on me. So we got a lot of guys in this locker room that are holding themselves accountable, you know, because I don't think it was his fault. I thought it was my fault.
Is that kind of everybody has to kind of chip in to help play the difference, so much attention that everybody else has to get.
Of course.
You know, you guys have bounced back well after bad losses this year. So it feels like you just need to shake that. Is that a fair assessment?
Yeah, shake the bad losses off. Yeah. But we're a good team. Yeah. We play the right way. We're one of the best teams in the league.